All right, here is the question of the week, number 5. Do you use your Bible's reference system? Sometimes it's printed on the side, making it a side column reference. Or if you have a 2-column Bible, it might be printed in the center, and this is called a center column reference. Your Bible's reference system is an invaluable Bible study tool. If your main study Bible, the edition of the Bible that you use the most, if it doesn't have a reference system, then you're really missing out. Each Bible publisher develops its own reference system. Most of them follow the same conventions, using superscripted numbers and letters in the running biblical text. The letters, that's what we're going to focus on in this video, the letters provide Bible citations that relate to the Bible verse you're looking at. Ephesians 4 verse 32 is one of my favorite verses. The English Standard Version reference system under H cites Colossians 3 verses 12 and 13, as well as 1 Peter 3 verse 8. These three passages all talk about forgiveness, compassion, kindness, and humility. The last sentence of Colossians 3 verse 13, as the Lord has forgiven you, you also must forgive, sounds a lot like the last phrases of Ephesians 4 verse 32, forgiving one another as God in Christ forgave you. Going back to the Ephesians 4:32 reference called I, there's brackets around 2 Corinthians 2 verses 7 and 10. The brackets indicate that the verbal connection between Ephesians 4:32 and 2 Corinthians 2 isn't as strong, but the editors are suggesting that this would be a good passage to consider in your study. Real quick, let's look at two more references in Ephesians. The Z reference for Ephesians 5 verse 22 says, for chapter 5, 22 through 6, 9, see Colossians 3, 18 through 4, 1. This is a clear indication that these two passages have a strong connection. They are, in fact, one of the so-called parallels between Ephesians and Colossians. I'm dropping down now to Ephesians 6, verses 21 and 22. The I reference cites Colossians 4, 7 through 9. Comparing the similarities between these two passages helps solidify in our minds that Ephesians and Colossians were indeed written back to back and delivered by the same people, namely Tychicus, and at least for Colossians, the slave Onesimus. If you're using a digital Bible, make sure it has a reference system. I'm a big fan of Logos Bible software, produced by Faith Life Corporation, and their app enables us to utilize each translation's reference system. The app has an outstanding hyperlink system built into it. So, here's the question of the week. Are you using this incredible Bible study tool, your Bible reference system? What are your thoughts about its use? Can you see how great a tool this is for sermon preparation or for a Bible class? For those of you more experienced, can you share with us how you have benefited over the years from using these for preparing a lesson? I'm really looking forward to reading your great responses. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next week.